Previously on Stinks.
Shut up! I'll get back!
Shit! Matt, officer down!
Male, 25. Injury wound on the nipple line left side. He's got an exit wound line with the left shoulder blade.
In a month or two, I'll be back with my unit.
You have to admit, it's highly unlikely.
The business with your friend, it bothered me.
Him getting shot, it bothered me too.
It's pretty hairy, this job you do.
Yeah, it can be.
I didn't think about that when we first started seeing each other.
One thing about my job, you learn how to improvise.
You're not the head of homicide anymore, Bill.
Yeah, well, thanks for reminding me.
If you
me
think
the
you
obvious...
can cover for your mates, we'll think again.
I'm just investigating a homicide, that's all.
Yeah, well, watch it. If I find you covering for Mackenzie, you'll be going down with her.
Thanks, Bill.
My pleasure.
Gonna relax, can you get a drink or a meal or something?
I'm pretty exhausted. I should have an early night.
All right.
Some other time?
Yeah.
Okay.
See ya.
Bye.
Hey, a quick someone, somewhere romantic to take someone to dinner?
The Stoke House?
Romantic?
Yeah.
The Stoke House, how's that sound?
You're gonna think I'm very strange, but let's do dinner after all.
Well, deep sleep's a good sleep. Coffee?
Mm-mm.
I had to get up and do something. I was thinking about what you said last night.
What did I say?
That the brass may be ready to bring me in from the cold. You weren't just humouring me.
Oh, no, with Diamond moving to special ops, I think you're a shoo-in for a reappointment.
Yeah, it'd be good to put all that behind us.
Mm.
Oh, sorry.
Coffee.
Look, I'll leave in the shower and let you finish your breakfast.
Mm-hmm. Well, you found the toaster. I'm sure you can find the towels.
Oh, by the way, I'd get that snore scene too. I can get a cab if you prefer.
No, it's fine. Anyway, I owe you for breakfast. Where'd you park?
Near the restaurant, a couple of blocks down Bird Street. Hollister. Yes, Ross. Well, how many? Oh, no. All right, I'll meet you there. There's a homicide at the docks. Can we divert there?
Maybe a cab would have been better. Wait here, eh?
I've got nothing to hide.
How's the girl?
Oh, yeah, hospitalised, suffering from dehydration and shock.
Was she able to tell you anything?
Oh, I couldn't get a word out of her, but through an interpreter, we've confirmed they're from Romania.
Part of a people smuggling operation?
Yes, immigration have been trying to cross them for some time, but they've just been too clever.
Until now?
Yeah. Look, I meant to say I enjoyed last night, and I hope you did too.
Yeah, it was nice. But now's not the time or place.
No, sure. But if you haven't got any plans later...
Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah. Oh, what about the container recipients?
Oh, we've ruled them out as suspects.
Huh?
They didn't even want the contents of the container after what's happened.
Can you blame them?
Well, we've got nothing else to go on, and, well, I need your help.
Was she able to speak any English?
Able, but unwilling, according to the interpreter.
Oh, maybe she just needs to be left alone for a while to assimilate what's happened.
Well, that's fine, but we've still got a job to do.
You're thinking of joining the circus church?
Oh, hearty ha ha. It's not for me.
No kidding. Who's the lucky bear?
It's Jesse's birthday. Any more questions?
Pretty fond of that kid, aren't you?
Yeah, well, it's easier when it's someone else's.
You really should consider a larger frame, Pete.
Oh, yeah. Don't you start. Hey, things hotting up at HQ.
What do you mean?
Hollister. Hit a homicide. Bet he's sweating on that gig.
Oh, we didn't discuss it. Morning.
Hey.
Right, then what did he want?
We're going after the snakeheads.
Well, that's not what it sounds like.
People smugglers, Chinese.
Fine, as long as it's not reptilian.
This just came in from HQ, mate.
Good guy, bad guy.
He's a customs officer. His name's Sean Duncan.
Uh-huh.
Why are we looking at him?
One of these customs people is obviously on the take, and this guy's bank account has shown some unexplained deposits over the past few months. The transactions are untraceable, and I don't think it's Tats Lotto.
You'd better dust off that old customs uniform, Pete.
Hang on. This may require the female touch.
I've got something else in mind for you.
Paging Dr. McLean to reception, please. Dr. McLean to reception.
Hi.
She's from Romania. Doesn't speak any English. I'll be back in a few minutes to take some obs.
Great. I'll look forward to that.
From Brisbane, eh? Get a bit hot for you, did it?
Oh, nothing happening up there, mate, you know. Typical public service mentality.
Yeah? How do you mean?
Dot the I's, cross the T's, collect the super. Lacking imagination, I reckon.
Yeah, well, not much difference here. It's pretty much the same setup, really.
Yeah? How often do you turn up with a dozen corpses in a container, then?
Yeah, well, even once is too often.
Who was down to inspect it?
Well, it was on my manifest. Would have been me.
I got ham and Swiss, okay?
Yeah, great. Oh, this one's yours, sorry.
Thank you. Nice to get out of the office, hmm? I don't want you to think what we did was a mistake.
I don't. It's just that... Well, it just happened, didn't it?
Good.
You know, it wasn't something I planned on.
No, neither had I. Well, that's not entirely true. I had thought about it.
Really?
Quite a lot, actually.
What? Since when?
Oh, only since the day we met.
Phil, you were married.
Unhappily, me. I lost change since.
I had no idea you were interested.
Who wouldn't be? You are extraordinary. Anyway, I don't want this to affect our friendship, it's important.
Oh, nor do I, nor do I.
But I'd still like us to keep seeing each other. But I sense your ambivalence.
I'm not ambivalent. I'm just getting used to the idea.
Yeah, okay, well, I don't want to crowd you. I'll leave things up to you. I have no expectations.
You are amazingly considerate.
I am, aren't I?
Ta-da!
Hey, did your car break down?
Oh yeah, everyone's a joker. What is it with this bike?
Oh, it's very generous of you.
Beautiful.
Jesse, come and say hello to Peter.
Happy birthday, birthday girl. Come here.
Hey, look what Peter brought you.
A bike.
Yeah. Whose birthday is it, huh?
It's the best thing I got all day.
Oh. What do you say?
Can I take it for a ride?
Sure you can. There you are. Yep. You alright? Give me a push. Ready? Go!
That's great. You know she's been at me for months to get her a bike.
Figure it couldn't hurt.
Oh, this looks good. Wow. Very brilliant. Yep. Who's that?
Jesse's father, Lyle. He's my ex.
And so say all of us. Hip hip
hooray!
Hip hip
hooray!
Hip hip
hooray!
Okay, who wants cake?
How's it going?
Yeah. I'm Peter. You're Jesse's dad, right?
Yeah, it's Lyle Lucas.
She's a great kid.
I can't believe how big she is.
How long since you've seen her?
Be 18 months, I guess. I've been working overseas.
Yeah? What sort of work do you do?
Muso.
Right. Where you been working?
All over. UK, Europe. They even picked up a few gigs in Egypt with some expats.
Egypt? Colourful.
Yeah. Oh, you get tired of it, though, after a while. You miss the comforts of home.
Where's that?
Well, I only just got back, so I don't really have a place to live as yet. Colleagues let me crash with her and Jesse for the time being.
At her place?
Yeah. Gives me an opportunity to get reacquainted with my daughter. Have you got a kid here, Peter?
Detectives and immigration authorities are still working to establish a link between the 11 people found dead in a shipping container and a people smuggling ring believed to be operating in Melbourne. The victims, all Romanian nationals, were thought to be illegal immigrants trapped in the container during the recent industrial dispute on the wharves. A spokesperson for the coroner has revealed the deaths were due to dehydration. An emotional young boy, missing since
hey. Hey, don't cry. It's not that bad in here. Are you in pain? Do you want me to call a nurse or something? Here, here's some tissues. I'm stuck in here too, so we may as well be friends. You can talk to me if you like. Well, if you change your mind, I'm right here.
Thinking about what you said yesterday, you know, how about that container's on your manifest?
Yes, so?
Well, I'm wondering, right, how the smugglers plan to get those illegals past the custom inspection in the first place?
Mate, how would I know?
Well, it's obvious, eh? There's got to be a man on the inside.
Yeah, maybe.
Tell you what, wouldn't like to be in that bloke's shoes right now, eh? Walking around with all those dead bodies on his conscience. Jeez.
Excuse me. Sean Duncan. Yeah, just a minute. Look, I'll catch you later.
Yeah, no worries. See you later.
Yeah? just got out of control. I don't want to talk about it on the phone, all right? Yeah, look, I'll slip away at lunchtime. Yeah, righto.
Having a look around, familiarising myself with the setup.
You're supposed to be over at Dock 9 clearing containers.
I'm on lunch. Thought I'd have a bit of a wander. Enjoy the sunshine, eh?
Suit yourself, bloody Queenslanders.
Throat was cut in broad daylight. I thought Church was supposed to be tailing him.
He had to keep it loose to avoid being seen.
Loose or slack.
It wasn't his fault, Bill. It happened so fast.
Our only lead is getting that girl to talk.
I've got someone on that as well.
Good, and I'm waiting on mugshots of possible suspects from the Romanian authorities to show up, all right?
I'll let you know as soon as we've broken through.
Hey, I'm counting on you, all right?
It's all worth a bloody Hollister. He should try it sometime. Did I mention my phobia about hospitals?
About 100 times.
I don't know about you, Mac, but I can't do it in a bedpan.
Just keep it low-key, will you?
Sorry. I'm just bored, you know?
Food here stinks of Brussels sprouts. I'm trying to get this girl to talk to me.
Church and Angie are working on another strategy. I just need you to get this girl's confidence, okay? And soon, if you can. There for you.
I'm going for a soft drink. You want them? Coca-Cola?
Come on, I know you can understand me. That word's recognised in every language.
Complaint has been made against you, Bullock.
What sort of complaint, sir?
Well, the complainant says that you attempted to solicit a bribe from her in return for undervaluing her dutiable goods.
Well, the complainant has obviously misinterpreted what I said.
He made it quite clear for a case of scotch, he was prepared to look the other way.
It's called humour. I don't even drink scotch, eh?
He's obviously a rotten apple. Look, if he were my employee, I'd get rid of him.
We'll get to the bottom of this, I assure you. Thank you for coming in. What's your story, Bullock? You've only been here 2 days and already you're trying to scam.
She's talking crap.
Did you ask her for a case of scotch?
I might have mentioned that 1 or 2 bottles could help fast-track a shipment. She's obviously taken it the wrong way.
I've got an officer murdered, police crawling all over the department. The last thing I need is this nonsense. You're on notice. Get out.
How are you settling in?
Well, I managed to get the boss offside. Guess that's not a bad start.
Likes to keep his nose clean. Doesn't mean we're all boring, though.
I'm sure you're not. Can I buy you a drink?
No, thanks. I have a reputation to protect. But I might get back to you. There are smarter ways to make quick cash, you know.
Cheers, mate. So how's the nursing business?
Fine. Busy. At least with Lyle around, I've got a free babysitter.
I guess it makes life easier when there's 2 of you.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. It's awkward.
Don't have to apologise.
It's just that he hasn't got a place to stay. I can't care.
It's fine. I know you've got Jessie to consider.
Yeah. She loves him, you know. God knows why. He's hardly been around most of her life. I was pregnant with her when he left. Said he didn't want to be a father. A bit late then. Anyway, he came back again a few years later.
You reconciled?
He said he'd matured. And I believed him till he did a runner. Anyway, now he's back and Jesse's over the moon.
I guess at Jesse's age, a father's still a father.
He wants to come back.
Have you told him about us?
Yeah. He wants me to think about it.
Are you? Thinking about it?
Hey, he's done this to me before. I'd be an idiot to fall for that again.
You're not,
No.
Sorry, forget I said that. Are you working tomorrow?
I've got an RDO.
What?
A roster day off. It's a real
great
job.
Great, let's have lunch.
Since when do you get a lunch break?
I'll take one.
Yeah, right. You won't turn up and I'll be sitting alone in
I will
cafe.
Be there. I will be there.
Where?
My place.
All right. You've got yourself a hot day.
Any pain?
Yeah, in the butt from lying in this bed.
And what about the tummy?
Oh, no, that's fine, surprisingly, considering the food. Rice custard, jelly trifle, fruit clafoutis. Jen, I wonder what that is. Sounds like some sort of venereal disease. Ah, a reaction, at last. How about a few words? No? Oh, come on. I know you can understand me. I'd really like it if you just talk to me. Just one little word. Just a moment.
Look here. No, don't do that. Don't do that. You'll set off the alarm.
What is it? What's the matter?
They will put me in a prison. And make me to go back to Romania. If I return there, they will kill me.
Here, take this. It'll help settle you down. Do you mind buzzing me if there's another problem?
At least tell me your name.
You can call me Nadia.
Nadia what? Have you got any relatives here in Australia? Relatives? You know, family.
My family died in the container. I saw it on the TV.
I'm sorry.
We wanted to start a new life in Australia. They told us when we get here, someone would open the container. But nobody came.
Do you want to tell me about it? Sometimes it helps to talk about
it. Easier to say. It was hot. And people died one by one.
You're lucky to be alive.
No. I wish I died with them.
How much extra cash are we talking about?
$1,000.
And what would I have to do?
Complete the paperwork on a certain container and clear it through. No inspection.
What's in it? Drugs?
You don't need to know that. It's better that you don't.
Why don't you clear it yourself?
You're either interested or you're not.
Oh, I'm interested.
Good. Container will be available for inspection around lunchtime. This one.
Short notice. What if I've got a hot date?
Not the job, you'll have to cancel. Container can't wait.
Fair enough. I'll take it. And the cash?
You'll get that when the container's released.
Bye, darling. You have a lovely afternoon, okay?
Bye, Mom.
See you.
We're going to have lots of fun, aren't we?
See you.
Bye.
Hello. Hi. No, I'm still at home. I thought that might happen. No, that's okay. We'll do it another time. Okay. Yep, bye.
Suspend their operations until things cooled off.
The container would have already been on its way.
We better bust them out immediately.
Or let it get picked up and delivered.
Come on, risk more deaths.
The translator who listened to the tape, he assures me they are all okay.
I don't know, Ellen, it doesn't sound good.
They've got water, food, and this may be our only chance of catching these guys.
All right, okay, let's do it.
Bravo 1, your package is on the moon,
Liza.
Thank you, Alpha 1. We have visual. Bravo 1 to all units. Target is heading south on Footscray Road. Pursue discreetly. Over.
Copy that. Bravo 2's in pursuit.
All units, let's not forget we've got human beings in there. Alpha 1, please confirm that we have medical support available. Over.
Copy that, Bravo 1. Paramedics and immigration are on standby.
Bravo 2 to Alpha 1. Please verify position of target vehicle. Over.
Target is turning east onto Eric Road.
Over.
Thanks, Alpha 1.
Alpha 1 to all units. We've just had confirmation from immigration that they'll be standing by with a translator.
Over.
Copy that. This is Bravo 1.
We're right behind the target and proceeding down Williamstown Road, heading towards the west gate. Over.
Copy that, Bravo 1.
Alpha 1 to all units, we appear to have arrived at our destination. Surround the area and maintain surveillance. Over. They've endured all this. The last thing they want is to get caught, thrown into a detention centre and sent back to where they came from.
At least this lot are still breathing.
Bravo 1 to Bravo 3, then follow that truck. Over.
My father, he tried for 10 years to get visas for us. Then I met someone. He said for $40,000, he can bring me here.
You paid them $40,000?
I didn't have it, but I made contract.
Mm. What kind of contract?
A work contract. I will work for them for 5 years to pay the debt.
Doing what?
A well-paid job.
Well, do you know who you're supposed to work for? Maybe I can help you find them.
No, they will be very angry on me.
Why should they be angry?
Because I am caught.
Nadia, why don't you talk to the police?
No. No police.
If you're afraid of these smugglers...
No, police are worse.
Nadia, listen to me. The police in Australia are different than in Romania.
No.
Nothing terrible will happen.
No.
If you just talk to them.
I will never talk to police. Never.
I don't think they're coming.
They'll come eventually. I'll give it a bit longer.
Maybe this was a bad idea.
It was your idea.
Well, then it's my call.
but I'm involved now.
One of us has got to make a decision.
Do you want to call it off?
Bravo 1 to all units, move in and get those people out of there.
Roger that, Bravo 1. All units move in now.
Detention centre at Port Adelaide will be an improvement.
Yeah, let's hope so.
They look like a perfect fit.
They are genuine Levi's?
I hope so. Otherwise, I've been ripped off.
How much did they cost?
About 100. To tell you the truth, they're a little small for me. You can have them if you like.
I can't believe it. This was my dream.
Size 8 was mine too. Oh well. They look good.
Do you have a car? With a CD player?
Well, I have a car. It's kind of old, though. No CD.
Just like in Romania. Everybody drives old junk.
Well, it does run. Most of the time.
Can you drive me somewhere?
Where do you want to go?
Anywhere. There.
Best I can do right now is get us a couple of soft drinks.
Yes, please. Are you expecting any visitors, Mick?
It's Oscar.
Oscar!
Hey, guys. Did you miss me?
Hardly noticed you were gone, did we, Mac?
How are you?
Oh, I'm feeling great. Well, never better, in fact. It's amazing what being shot can do for you. Just kidding. But look, I don't want you to tread on eggshells around me or anything. I'm feeling fine with it, really.
Yeah, well, you're looking great.
Hey, I'm indestructible. If it doesn't kill you, you know.
Have you been up to the farm?
No. I've been spending a fair bit of time at the gym, doing the circuit, some weights.
You're not overdoing it, I hope.
Nah. Hey, you know I can press more now than I could before the shooting.
Really?
Yeah. I'm ready to get back into it. Raring to go.
I might just have a word. Oscar, you are on rehab leave, and as much as we all love you, you're not even meant to be here.
Yeah, well, look, I wanted to talk to you about that.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I said, I'm feeling great. I think I'm ready to come back.
You're ready when your psych and medical evaluations say you are.
Oh, come on, Mac. Didn't you hear what I said? I can press...
Yeah, I heard the sales pitch. Look, I can't even put you on light duties until we've had medical clearance.
I'm going stir crazy at home. I want to work.
I sympathise, but you know what the regulations are, okay? Go home. See Nadia?
Well, she had a visitor here a moment ago.
here.
Working to pay off your debt.
What do you intend to do with me?
Yeah.
I don't owe you anything.
Yeah.
Whoa. Whoa. Spenny girl.
I'll see him now. Hang on.
Peter, wait.
We just got word from the hospital. Now, Danny and Nadia have gone missing. They may have been abducted.
But what, by the smugglers?
We think so. Now, this customs woman, what's her name?
Whittle.
We need her contact, now.
Onto it.
Yeah. Very nice. She will be good earner for us.
Look, if it's a matter of money, I can pay off her debt. Just let us go.
Yeah. So you can run straight to the cops.
She's underage.
You shut up. You interfere enough.
What do you want? Just let her go.
What are we going to do about her?
What do you think?
Yeah. What is it? Shit. Another problem at the dock. I'll deal with this later.
Whittle tells me you have a problem, Mr. Bullock. I'll be paying you enough.
Not if you expect me to take heat from the cops. That costs extra.
Sure, you can come to some arrangement.
I want to know what I'm involved with here.
You are trafficking in human beings.
Think of us as alternative travel agents.
Can't say I'm too impressed with your safety record.
That was unfortunate.
You have to believe me, they're worth more to us alive.
That's a code 3, everybody. All units, move in.
Unfortunately, your excess baggage.
Police! Don't move! You better pray this to the line! Now, where are they? Speak up, you bastard!
In here!
Let's get you in here.
It took you so long.
Can I have a word?
Yeah, sure.
Now's probably not the right time or place, but I'm curious about one thing.
What?
Why me?
You make great Vegemite toast.
So being a balding 42-year-old divorcee isn't relevant.
I'll get back to you.
I got something to do. You mind if I get out of here?
Yeah, sure, go for it.
Hey, you seen Nadia?
No.
Don't tell me we've lost her.
Well, she probably freaked out when the cops came. Well, she's most probably hiding somewhere.
All right, she'll be around. Let's keep looking.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody moving.
Sorry, mate. She's agreed to give me another chance. We're moving to Sydney.
Oh, yeah? When did Collette decide this?
Does it matter? The point is, she's made her choice. No one's home, mate.
She's gone already.
She don't want to put Jesse through a tearful goodbye.
Who said I'd cry? I hope you're around until she's 18, mate.
Thanks for letting me know, Bill. Can we discuss that later? I'm just in a meeting right now. Okay, bye.
Hey, has he got any word on Nadia?
She's on the missing persons register. But immigration says she could be anywhere by now.
In the end, she'd rather work as a sex slave than be sent to a detention centre.
So much for a better life in Australia.
Yep.
Hello. So, your place or mine?